Okay, now we've done the work in the store, let's go across and update our activity filter components that we created earlier and give it some functionality. So what we're going to need to do, we're going to need to make this an observer. We need to observe the values from the store in this case. So that's the first thing we'll do. We'll just turn this function into an observer to give it those extra powers to observe from the store. And then what we'll do is we'll get our activity store and we'll say use store. And we only need two properties from the activity store. So just in the same line, I'm just going to destructure the predicates and the set predicate function. And then we can go configure our different menu items. So I'll just bring this down. And what we want to do here is we want to make it active if the predicate is set for this menu item. So we'll use the active property and then we can look at our predicate and see if it has the all key. Now we're only allowing our user to select one of these filters at a time. So if it has the all key, then that's the one that's going to be selected on our menu. And then we'll just add the on click event. And what we want to do is add the expression and say set predicates. And we're going to say all. And the value is a string here, so we can't just use true, but we can use true in quotes. And what I'll do is I'll just copy these two lines and I'll do the same for the second one and just paste these in, but this time it's going to be is going and the predicate's going to be is going. And I'll just do the same for the third one and paste in those two lines and swap all for is host and do the same for the onClick event. And then we just need to do the calendar. And all we need to do here is give this the onChange property. And inside here, we can get the date that's being selected. And we can say set predicates. And we can specify the start date as the key. And then the date as the value. But in this case, it's either a date or a date array. We've only got a single date. So what we'll do is specify as date to remove the warning from there. And then we just need to give it its value. And we'll use predicates.get and start date. And if we don't have the date, then we'll just set it to today's date, which will just be a new date. And that should be all we need to do. So what we can do now is go test and let's just refresh this page. And all activities is highlighted with the current date as it is today. And if I click on I'm going, then we see, well, we should see all the activities that Bob is going to. And that looks fine. We're not seeing any empty flags. And if I click on I'm hosting, then we should see just the activities that Bob is hosting. And let's make sure the date functionality works as well. So if I pick a date after the 6th of Feb, and I'll just go into early March and select the date, then the February activity has been removed and we're just seeing activities after that date. And if we select all activities and we just go into the past and let's select 2nd of December, then we should see the previous activities after that date as well. And that's what we're looking for, but the experience is pretty awful. The full page loading every time we click on one of these filters is not particularly responsive feeling. And we're going to look at changing that in the next lesson by introducing placeholders.